Okay, today, so we're going to take a look at how to make a nice ambient loop to add some character and interest in your track. So let's say you have a really simple track with just a drum loop and a bass and a synth, something like this. And that would go on and on, and that's fine. That could work in some cases, but for me, I want something that's a little more interesting, a little more textured, to kind of back all that up. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna take a loop. In this case today, I used a bongo loop to make it sound a little bit more interesting, and it sounds like this. Now in that case, it becomes a little bit more ambient sounding, and that's what I wanted for the track, so that's great. So I'm going to show you step by step how I went through and made this. You can already see a lot of the settings at the bottom of the screen, but let's kind of build it from the ground up. So to start with, the first thing you need to do is find a sound that you think is interesting. You can either, of course, make your own loop, or you can find someone else's that you've downloaded. So in my case, I've got a loop library here, and I liked this bongo sound. So the bongos at 130 beats per minute. Let's do this one. All right, so I'm going to drag that out here. Put that away for a minute. And let's solo and just hear what it sounds like. A little too busy for what I was envisioning. So let's begin first of all by slowing it down. So we can go ahead and not click that one, but click this button twice to slow down the clip. And to make this sound good, be sure that you choose the Complex Pro algorithm. All right, let's try that again. So that's getting to a tempo that I like. So the next step is that we want to, or I want to, reverse this. So let's go ahead and reverse the sample. And it's going to add a little bit of interesting character to it. Starting to sound a little otherworldly. Now what I like to do is kind of time it up. So I'm going to put warp markers at the big transients I see, just these three big guys, and put them on the third beat of the first bar, the first beat of the second bar, and the third beat of the second bar. And let's see how that sounds. All right, that sounds really cool. So now, what I'd like to do is start adding some effects. So let's go back into our browser over here and look at audio effects. Clear our search. The first thing I want to do is put an auto filter, and I'm not really going to use the auto part of the auto filter, just going to use the filter part. So let's play it and see what it sounds like. So still sounds about the same. Let's go down and choose a band pass filter and go down somewhere between 500 and 900K. I'm sorry, not K, 500 and 900 hertz. That's a little too low. Let's go. I like that, around 754. Okay, so that kind of makes the sound a little more manageable for us. Let's also add another great Ableton effect, this resonator. So I happen to know that my song is in the key of C, and we can see that the first resonant harmonic they're creating here is already on C2, so that's great. Let's change number 2 here to 7, so that's a fifth, then 12, an octave, and let's do 19, so an octave of the first fifth, and then 24, so two octaves up. So that adds a really nice sound to the loop. It gives it some tonality, which the bongos didn't really have that much of. Another thing you can do to add some more texture that I really like is this corpus effect. So let's put the corpus as the first effect in the chain. And again, here we can see it's already tuned to C, which is the key of our song, so that's great. let's go through. I think I like the maybe membrane. Oh, that creates a really cool sound. How about plates? Pipe? I think I like tube for this one. And you can play around with the dry wet, so completely the sound of the corpus texture, or a dry sound. I'm gonna do something around 42. All right, so now what I'd like to do is kind of get some more movement, because it's kind of a static loop at the moment. So let's drag in a phaser here. And we're gonna first just go over to the LFO section. And my favorite LFO shape is the bottom one, the crazy one. And just drag it up to 100% so we can see what it sounds like. And you can play with your rate. I like to go into the synced rate and do something like maybe a fourth note. And now we can play with where we want this to be. I like to put it somewhere around where the auto filter was. So this sounds good. Also, I like to put it up to 8 poles. And then we can bring the amount back down a little bit. Blend it to how we like it. So I'm going to do something like, again, 42, 43. All right, so that's a pretty cool, interesting sounding loop, but I'd like to make it kind of bigger and more ambient sounding. So what we can do is go up to create, and we want to insert a return track. You can see I've already got one here. We're going to be recreating it. This return track is going to house our reverb plugin. Now I like to start the reverb plugin kind of as a blank slate, so I like to turn all this stuff off. And I like to make sure that the quality is set to high. So let's go ahead and pull this signal into our send, and in this case, this is a B send. So turn it all the way up, and you can start to hear that reverb coming in. Let's turn the size all the way up, and lengthen the decay to around 10 seconds, close to 10 seconds. It's huge. And since this is a return, let's put the dry and wet all the way up to 100%. So if we solo that, we can just hear this really wonderful, eerie reverb going on. And that's gonna add a lot of character to our track. All right, so. That's sounding pretty good, but one more thing that we can actually do to this is add a compressor, just to get everything a little more manageable. What I like to do is just, again, solo the sound. Let's get a 4-to-1 ratio and bring the threshold down till we're doing quite a bit of gain reduction. Sounds pretty good. So now you're getting a little bit more of an even level that you can manage. So let's bring that back in. And that's a great way to add some effect and some mood to your track. And I like to do this because sometimes you can really play with the different effects that you put on this. For example, the resonator. You can change the pitches and create these complex chords. And this is helpful not only in filling out an arrangement that you've already made, but also in kind of brainstorming ideas for an arrangement you might be stuck on. Try and add a new loop in there and see what flavors, what colors it adds to that arrangement. And maybe you can build off of that to finish up your song. All right, so I hope that helped you. Again, please check back in the future. I'm going to have some more tutorials up soon. So I hope you enjoyed. Please comment, let me know what was good, what was bad, and I'll see you next time.